In this video, we have
stock and super stock,
factory supercars,
open comp,
nostalgia super stock,
high true street passes,
and pro mod.
This is a long video. If you would like to skip to our favorite classes or some of the items that I have filmed, please pause the screen and check out the timestamps I have listed.
At the NMCA Finals in Indianapolis, my favorite place to be, the drag strip, and I'm racing in two street class this year. Watch along and enjoy the show.
Here is another screen you may wish to pause and check out. It lists some of the abbreviations that I have used throughout this video.
burnout box, yellow car. Not the same. I don't think I've ever seen it caught a banana in the engine. So he stole some bananas on the way to the track. Andy whispered it out of her.
Hello.
Thank you. 7 and 120. 1105 with a 7 and 120.
One of the most embarrassing things ever happened to me while I was at the track. I locked my keys in my car. Didn't want to set the alarm because it would be going off constantly with open headers, vehicles going by all the time. So I manually locked the doors, and later in the day I came back to get back in the car and realized I didn't have my keys in my pocket. Well, there they were in the ignition. So I strolled over to the True Street lady, Jessica, and asked her if she knew if anyone on the grounds could unlock a car, and she got on her radio, and a few minutes later she said, yep, the guy down at the top end of the track has locksmith keys, or tools, he'll be up here in a minute. And sure enough, here he came, and he wouldn't take a dime for it. He said unlocking it was courtesy of the NMCA, so kudos to the NMCA for such friendly staff. It's one of the reasons I go back each year. They're just such nice people. Obviously it's a time lapse, but here I'm signing papers and waivers and such, and getting the car teched in. Some rainfall earlier in the morning, so I thought I might have a little trouble finding a dry spot to park, and I was right. I, as you'll see here, cruised through the pits in the area where the True Street competitors park, and all the grass either had water standing around it or was muddy that was available, so I parked along the back of the staging lanes. Now that the car has been teched in, I went back to my parking spot and started applying the decals that are required to compete in the True Street class. The old 2000 Trans Am has nearly 145,000 miles on it, 15-year-old street tires, a few mild modifications, and only requires a few more minor modifications to make it legal for the interesting class. Basically just some stickers. And then we just get in and go. I almost forgot, I need slightly modified too with these armbands. After our one test pass, we gathered under the True Street tent for a driver's meeting to go over a few rules and kind of outline the 30-mile cruise route. side of the track. Right now I am on the west side of the track, headed for gate number 8, and we'll just call this an impromptu pit cruise. For the 30-mile True Street cruise, we will be following a pace vehicle, and there will also be a trailing pace vehicle. We are not allowed to pass the pace vehicle or fall behind the trailing pace vehicle. Either action will result in disqualification. After the 30-mile cruise, we will return to the track and make our 3 back-to-back passes. This tech official is telling everyone to line up nose to tail behind the pace vehicle.
Here, again, everything you expect from the best in the business. Otherwise, you can't win a thing. finished our 30-mile cruise, and now we're in the staging lanes awaiting our three back-to-back passes.
language, I was pretty excited with this pass. It was actually my fastest pass ever in this car by over 2/10. It's got almost 145,000 miles on it, but it just, keeps going faster. This is even on street tires that I have to feather off the line because they won't hook for nothing. So that was pretty awesome. After our three passes and some time allowed for them to tally up the stats, we had a awards meeting under the True Street tent again. We'll be right back. After a long, fun-filled day, it's time to head home. I made every effort to give credit to all the cars and drivers shown in this video. I used various sources to obtain the info used to align the folks with their vehicles. The internet and the entry list for the event were a huge help. However, there were a few that I could not label due to either lack of info or inability to tell the names and or car numbers on the footage I took. If you are one of those folks that got left out or not credited correctly, I wish to give you my deepest apologies. No ill will was intended.